There's something missing in this review. Akio Twin. Now let's get into this review. Yo, what's going on YouTube? It's your boy Alex Thomas here, back with my twin brother here, you guys, and today we're here to talk about one of our favorite franchises, one of our favorite movies of all time. We are here to talk about Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone, you guys. Directed by Chris Columbus, starring Daniel Radcliffe, Emma Watson, Rupert Grint, Alan Rickman. This cast is freaking phenomenal. Amazing. For this movie, and we're gonna give you our thoughts and our our feelings, our favorite moments about this movie. If you guys are enjoying these videos, please hit that like button, please subscribe for more Harry Potter reviews will be coming in the near future. I'm trying to review all the movies leading up until Fantastic Beasts and the Secrets of Dumbledore. Hope you guys will stick with me with this review series. My brother will be on here for a couple reviews, not all of them, because there's some ones he doesn't like as much as other ones, so he's going to be on the ones that he really will enjoy. So let's go ahead and get into the review. Let's get it. Let's go. All right, like I said, starting off with Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone. Myron, tell everybody what your thoughts on Harry Potter and Sorcerer's Stone.
This is definitely top five of my favorite movies of all time.
Yes, sir.
It's my top five. Like, it goes back to when we were kids. We didn't get to see it in theaters, but we was blessed for our uncle, you know what I mean, to get it for us on pay-per-view. Mm-hmm. We watched that 24/7.
We watched it every single time.
We watched it till we left his house.
Right.
We was over there for the weekend, and my uncle said, he just got it for us. And he knew we wanted to get it. He knew we wanted to watch it. And we had an amazing time watching. We knew the lines before we left his house. That's
yes.
Facts.
Yes. And like I said, this movie is about a kid who lives with his terrible aunt and uncle. He feels like something is off. Weird things are happening around him. He magically gets a letter from Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry. And after all this stuff happens, a large giant named Hagrid comes and tells him, bro, you're a wizard. So, and your parents were wizards, and all this stuff happened with them dying and stuff like that. And after that, he gets swooped into this magical world of the wizarding world. And the one thing I got to give credit with this movie is that this movie, it has a very magical feel to it. Yes, right, it when you get into it. Right, mm-hmm. When he gets into Diagon Alley, exactly. You're swept into this world, mm-hmm. And you got to give credit to Chris Columbus. Yes. With the way he made this film, and you also got to give credit to the actors themselves for actually buying this stuff. One thing I always think about watching this stuff is that these actors are world-class actors, especially overseas. Yes. These actors are known for, you know, the work they do. Right. And they bought in to this world, to these characters, to this script,
right,
and stuff like that. And it mind boggles me that things like this can actually make sense and really be good on the screen.
Exactly. Especially for it being from a book.
Yes.
You know what I mean? A lot of things for books don't really successful, but for this being, you know what I mean, from a book, it was really phenomenal. And for this being, it really head on the book too. Like, this is literally the book. If you never read the book, you don't have to read the book. You can watch the movie. There's certain things they don't have in the book, but the movie is technically the book. They took everything from the book, and I give it to them. That was actually an excellent movie. It's definitely my top five.
Yes, sir. That's the one thing, got to give credit as well, because J.K. Rowling wasn't that involved, but the screenwriter, Steve Kloves, went to J.K.
Right.
And made sure he got the most points that he needed to get to write the script as great as he can. Same with the production design. I can't think of what the guy who was in charge of doing the production, mm-hmm. and he went to J.K. as well to try to figure out what does this world look like. And I think they really did a great job showing it on the screen. Like, that first shot when we get the kids on the boats and they go up to Hogwarts. And John Williams' score. Amazing. Oh, my God. It's a very humble score. And like I said, certain scenes like that really makes you feel very magical and very... Yes. Whisked into this world, it's amazing. It's really fantastic.
It makes me want to be one of the kids on the boat every time I watch it. Like, I want to be in this world. I want to be here. I want to be one of these kids exploring different things I never seen before. What am I about to do? Like, it was amazing.
For sure. Like, another thing I have to give credit to as well is that the school does the school itself, to me, is a character itself. Like, it's its own thing. Like, right. It's a lot of things that's involved with the castle itself. And I love that, like, the first scene we get with Dumbledore telling all the kids, like, about the school, like, you can't go to certain places because you might die.
Right.
Like, it's things like that that makes right. you like, wow, this is actually real.
Right.
And they really take this stuff seriously, and exactly. You got to give credit to it. Now, I'm going to get into some negatives because this movie is not perfect. It's a great movie, but there are some flaws. It suffers from the point that it's a lot of exposition, basically just building up to a lot of things.
Right.
So you feel like you're getting explained a lot of stuff.
Right. You are,
but with the first movie or book series, eight movies in or seven books in, it's like, okay, you have to do this. Another thing I have to say as a negative for me is some of the CGI, like some of the special effects.
Remember what the time was.
Yeah, it was 2001. Right, 2001. And also, like, to me, well, everyone complains the Quidditch match is the weakest part of not the match itself, but the special effects wise.
Right, because it's all special
effects. It's all CGI, it looks like everyone is like video gamey, like everybody like PlayStation 2 characters.
Right.
But another thing why I have to fall back on that is that was like the last thing they did. They literally were shooting the Quidditch match like a month before they actually released the movie, so that I kind of give them they were still making the Quidditch match like really late in progress of the movie being shot.
That would look like a difficult scene to shoot, though. As far as like everything being CGI,
for sure.
To really get them,
for sure.
Yeah, that would be difficult, I believe, around that time too.
For sure.
Around that time.
One thing we didn't really talk about is the main three cast. We got
Harry,
Daniel Radcliffe, Rupert Grint. Emma Watson was cast as these roles. Most of them were. This was their first acting gigs, and you got to give credit because they were actually really good.
Daniel
Radcliffe. No, this was like his second or third role. He was in a couple small indie stuff. And the funny story about this is that his parents didn't even want him to be in this movie.
Yeah, the thing is, when they seen him, they say that's Harry Potter. I remember watching the little documentary they had, and you know, I mean, Christopher Columbus. That would say that was the last thing that they had to do him. Yep. That was the last thing they had to do. And that was good they found him. No lie, I'm blessed that they found him, because if without him, we wouldn't have what we have today is one of the best franchises of all time.
Hands down,
one of the best franchises
for
of all
time. I think Christopher Columbus did a great job with these kids.
Exactly.
And he really knows how to work with kids well. Obviously, he did the first two Home Alone movies.
Yeah, right.
So
he
knows how to really work with children, how to get the best performances.
And I did get that vibe from the first two. I do get that verse.
Like Home Alone 2
vibes. I definitely got that vibe.
Yeah, for sure.
And that's what made me feel like a kid inside.
For this to be the first entry of a franchise, this is how you do it right.
It
has that childlike feel, but also adults like us can still sit there and watch it. Like, you can sit there and show your kids this movie and still feel the magic, and the kids can also feel the magic as well. So you got to give credit to this franchise as well for doing that. You got any more closing thoughts you want to talk about Harry Potter and Sorcerer's Stone?
Nah, we basically covered everything. If you want to talk about the main antagonist, you didn't talk about the...
We need to talk about some of the supporting cast. We got Alan Rickman showing up as Professor Snape. We got, I think his name is Richard Harris, showing up as Dumbledore. Rest in peace. He was great as Dumbledore. I think Alan Rickman was perfectly cast as Severus Snape.
He was.
We got the main antagonist. His name is Voldemort. Basically, he's basically the big bad of the entire franchise.
Right.
I think he was kind of the weakest part as well. I think
he was.
The actor playing Professor Quirrell was kind of weak as well.
He was weak. And I think that's what made him control him.
Yeah.
Because he was weak. And he really didn't know what to do because he was getting taken over by Voldemort.
Right.
And he wanted Voldemort, all he wanted to do was get out. That's all he wanted to do was get out.
He wanted, then the whole premise of this movie is that the Sorcerer's Stone gives a person the elixir of life and makes them immortal. And Voldemort wants to get the stone from, you know, he wants to get the stone.
He wants to be
his own being now.
Right. Because he's not a being. He's technically a sarm of... It's hard to explain.
I would say he's like a parasite.
Yeah, because
like
he's attached
to somebody else.
Right. Because if you were to think, like, far as, like, the part where we was in the Dark Forest and we was like, what was he then? Like, was that Professor Quirrell?
Yeah, I think that was Professor Quirrell in the Dark Forest.
But you get
scenes like that, which is great, though, because you got very dark, eerie moments in this movie. And you definitely got those.
And it's definitely... I like that they cover, basically, certain parts of... seasons in there.
This movie spans the whole school year, which I do like.
I do like a lot
of different holidays. The Halloween scene, you get the Christmas scene.
Yes.
You get a lot of different parts of the year.
Right.
Which
the second makes you see him grow up in this.
Right.
You see him grow up.
Right.
Like you said, in the scene where he says at the end, where he says he's not going home, not really, that gives me goosebumps
every
time he says it. Because I think I'm about to say he's right, because he doesn't call... the Dumbledore. He don't call the Dursleys home. Yeah. He don't call them no. He calls
Hogwarts home. Yeah, now, that's the one thing you got to give credit to this movie that I wish they nailed and give it on that the coffin. Feel. Yeah, it gives you that great warmth and that great magic. And that's what I'm saying. That's the magic of Harry Potter.
Like the part where he first get there, right? So he's sitting in a window. He's looking out the window like, I'm not in that room no more. He's just sitting there like.
Yeah, when he's sitting looking out the window and like touching head to it. Yeah, that's a great scene.
So I was thinking about it, yeah, you really did. You're not there no more. You're about to discover some real things. You're about to really see what life is really like. Yeah.
You get a lot of moments. Like, you get also the moment with him with Hedwig again when he's walking and he releases him.
Yeah.
And Hedwig is flying away.
Right.
Yeah, and you get a lot of moments like that with Harry. Mm-hmm. And then you get another moment where he's discovering the castle and he finds the mirror Erised.
Yeah.
That moments like that, which why I love this movie.
Bro. And if you know that Harry's an eager beaver.
Yeah, he loves to walk around and discover things. But yeah, that's why I think that's the great thing about his character.
Right. And that's why everybody fall into him.
Yeah, for sure.
He's definitely eager. He's definitely willing to go do some things. He's definitely willing to take that
risk.
And that's what makes him really strong. And that's what I give that. And I love about this because that really shows you can conquer anything.
Yeah, for sure. But would you recommend? Obviously, we definitely would recommend this movie.
If you haven't seen it, you are late.
Yeah, and definitely watch it.
And you're not a nerd because it's definitely a good movie. It definitely shows. It gives a really points in life. It's definitely real. It's really real life. You put it that way.
Yeah, for
definitely
sure.
Definitely real life. Got a lot of stuff going on.
For sure. Like I said, I definitely recommend it. Overall, Harry Potter and Sorcerer's Stone is a really great start to an amazing franchise. Definitely show it to your kids. You had young kids. They would really enjoy it. I don't see how they would not enjoy it.
They would enjoy it.
Yeah, for sure.
I would see they would get a fright in a couple of times, but we was kids. We got frightened a little time. We got frightened. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir. It's all right. But yeah, so like I said, that's our review for Harry Potter and Sorcerer's Stone. Let us know what you guys thought about Harry Potter and Sorcerer's Stone in the comment section below. But if you're from the UK, it's called Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone.
Right.
I know I got some UK people watching my videos. You guys are awesome. Thank you guys for checking out my videos. If you guys want more videos, please hit that like button. Please subscribe for more. More Harry Potter reviews will be coming in the near future. I hope you guys are ready for that as well. And we're on this one, you guys. Peace out.